Breathlessness was uneasy. There was an emptiness that surrounded him, a great shadow of the unfulfilled. He worked as a pseudonym developer for the Uninfused with Life Corporation. His clients were mostly wealthy dilettantes who wished to be given an entirely different identity. They no longer wanted to live as who they were, but as who they wished they could be. Bartholomew didn't blame them. With all that's happened since the transition, it's little wonder that people would like to forget about the inescapable bleakness around them. The job paid very little in terms of coin credits, but it was enough to keep Bartholomew out of the camps. One day, as Bartholomew was in his zone quarters, receiving his daily news stream on the hollow prism, his attention was suddenly brought into great focus by an advertisement he'd never seen before. An attractive woman in a sheer sky blue robe who seemed to be walking at once through clouds and time itself was extolling the virtues of a process called afterlife sequencing that had been developed by a company called Death Solutions. For a fee, which was actually quite a few coin credits, far more than Bartholomew ever wished he could have, Death Solutions promised to change your life forever by changing your death. Rather than just leaving your afterlife experience up to random chance, you could engage in the intensive conditioning of afterlife sequencing now that would allow you to have the death of your dreams later. As the advertisement went on, Bartholomew learned that you can create the eternity that you deserve. It's all in the mind. No more torturous and fiery hells await, for control is being given to you. True, no one had really believed in the old myth much anymore, especially not after the transition, but Bartholomew could not shake the feeling that some terrible, larger fate awaited him, lurking just around the corner of this life, until it caught him by surprise and devoured him. The advertisement stirred a fire of such intensity in Bartholomew, it would shock him when he felt its flames inside. Why should he be stuck inventing new lives for people while ignoring the dark fate that lay ahead for him? It just wasn't right. He deserved much more, especially after what he went through in the transition. He wanted no more pain forever. But he couldn't get carried away with this. Bartholomew reminded himself, he couldn't even afford a new pseudonym in this life, let alone afterlife sequencing from Death Solutions. He couldn't be so foolish as to get caught up with this fancy. Still, the days wore on, and Bartholomew couldn't stop thinking about what might lie before him across the veil. He would find his mind wandering constantly, often tuning out his clients, or gazing blankly at the hollow prism, even when it was beaming images from his favorite evening series, Trees. Trees. Yes, that was precisely it. For years, Bartholomew had been squirreling away coin credits in hopes of one day moving far beyond the zone into what used to be called the country. Everyone had seen trees on the hollow prism, and heard tales of the trees in the country. Well, there was actually one still remaining. Although apparently, they used to be everywhere. Bartholomew had always dreamed of leaving the Uninfused with Life Corporation, and with his stash of coin credits, moving to the country to live by that tree. It did wonders for the skin, Bartholomew would tell himself. And who knows? It might just be the place to finally feel safe and free from that perpetual haunting shadow. Excitedly, Bartholomew entered the various biometric permissions necessary to unlock his encoded coin credit statement on the phono box. Almost immediately, Bartholomew heard his coin credit total read out to him in a slow, measured, very near to human voice. And almost just as immediately, Bartholomew fell into a numb blankness. He had enough coin credits in his tree account to undergo afterlife sequencing, even if it had to be on one of the economy pricing tiers. It was better than nothing, and far better than what any old tree could provide him. The next several weeks were a whirlwind of activity for Bartholomew. There were daily appointments at the Death Solutions offices, beginning with consultations, but quickly turning into conditioning sessions. Bartholomew spent an increasing amount of time hooked up to various machines and receiving transmissions of various fluids. His brain was bombarded with all of the electrical stimulus it could handle. As the technician said after one particularly draining and painful session, "It takes a lot of energy to change the future, let alone all of eternity." Bartholomew frequently returned to his zone quarters completely exhausted, with no appetite and with an enormous headache. He suffered memory lapses as well, and there was a ringing in his ears. "This will all be worth it in the end," he would soothingly remind himself as he slipped into a fried slumber. It was on one of these blank, metallic, dreamless nights that Bartholomew never woke up again. He heard the shrieking winds of the transition, but they were all inside of his head. He smelled the fire and felt the gathering clouds. He saw a cascading rush of color and light rapidly leave his skull until there was nothing but blackness. There was no more pain. There was no more Bartholomew Iris. There was nothing at all. This was his death solution.